Kumusta kayo lahat? Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, the basketball show for the Filipino community. My name's PJ. Joining me are my co-hosts. We got Marky Mark over here with the scarf. And we got JR. Both of them are wearing black. FTV revamped. I'm happy to be here. We have a lot of things to talk about the draft, and about certain things that are happening in the offseason, I mean, for the teams that are not involved. But, yeah. So I'm excited because next a few episodes, I kind of have a brainchild. I want to introduce a new show that Mark and I actually shot at a gym. It's called, I don't know what to call it. I was calling it MBA, Mini Hoops or Mini Basketball Association. So I kind of wanted to showcase these little kids. It's more of a lighthearted sports basketball broadcast. We got little kids playing. They don't know how to play. They like push each other. They like shoot. The score is really low. It's like,
I don't think we record. We just kind of like let them play, kind of see. There's a couple of times when they scored a lot. So I was like, oh. And then like, the thing is like, not only do the parents go crazy, like they go crazy when they score, because they're like, oh, I never thought I could score. And then they just.
Yeah, I know JR wasn't with us when we were doing the broadcast, but what do you think about, I guess, my idea? Because like,
What do you expect when you think of NBA? Because he's never seen it.
When you think of little kids playing basketball in a serious game, what do you think it would look like?
I think what makes it intriguing for like audience like me trying to wait for this show to come out is that, you know, it's going to be a fun, heart-filled show. Little kids playing sports. We don't have that much, you know, especially what's, you know, going on in the world. We want to have some lighthearted shows or like some entertainment value that we can actually check out, have some fun, have some laughs here and there, you know, enjoy these guys, letting them have fun as well, because I know they probably had fun playing basketball, whether they're playing it properly or not. I mean, they're still young kids. Like, how old are they?
5 to 7 years old. Yeah. So some of them barely can dribble. Some of them can barely
hold the ball.
Yeah.
So expectations will be like really good. Mm. This being a young demographic of looking, watching it, and you know, having a fun comedic show, but not, you know, laughing at them too much, because you know, they're just young kids. They're just first time playing basketball.
And Mark was actually the referee. What did you feel like when you were?
I was tired. Oh my god, because it's not only like you have to run back and forth with them to keep up, and they have a lot of energy. Also, you have to kind of tell them, oh, you can't do that. Oh, you can't hold that person.
I can't hold that person.
Oh, yeah, that's your teammate. That's your teammate. You can't steal the ball from your own teammates, kind of thing. And yeah, you can't keep running with the ball. Oh, that's you're out of bounds. So it was a lot of like, not just trying to make sure that they are having fun, but also don't get hurt. So a couple times when they try to pass the ball, no one's looking, and then bam, right in the head. So
it was like, we got some injuries over there. But that's the first thing, kind of our surprise that we kind of launch after this FTV revamp. So we got that NBA Mini Basketball Association. So that's for the little kids. If you have any little kids, sign them up. It's just for the cuteness, really cuteness overload. Yep. But the other things that we still have to show you guys, we were at GTA Hoops a couple of days ago, and there were some good games, some familiar faces. We had Phil Can again, obviously. Yeah. Phil Can versus, what was the team that they faced?
Open?
Yeah, Open.
Oh, Philak, right?
Philak. Yeah.
Shout outs to Norman. I got you some shots. Shout out to Mark Sweetie, who's he was trying to get some good awesome shots with me with him getting busy with the sport. I don't know what he was drawing in his board. You were drawing something. I knew you were drawing something. Shout out to your cousin, godbrother. I mean, your godbrother was there. It was an interesting result. Stay tuned, because there's some interesting story behind it about the winnings and some. And also, you shot a couple of juvenile games too, right?
Yeah, we shot three games. We got the Open, which ended prematurely, and then we had the Bayan versus Crossover. So that's some of the kids that played in the Philippines were there. We had Denzel doing a nice behind the back.
Oh, we'll give away too much.
Okay,
it's nice.
GTA. And then we have another. We shot three games, so watch out for those videos. And then the last, I guess, thing that we want you guys to be prepared for is MCup. MCup's coming, so the hype is big. What can we expect, or what should we look forward to MCup? I guess.
Yeah, it's been a lot of a lot of the leaders or the organizers of the MCup. Shout outs to Clyde, Mark Sweetie, Ray came into our show talking about a little bit about it, giving us a little bit of teasers in terms of what's happening. But they don't want to give the full on what's happening in the actual MCup. But they told us that it's going to be big. A lot of teams that's going to be not just, they opened it up not just to the Filipino community, but they've opened it up to anyone that's really want to play and competitive basketball.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
And it's very exciting because, you know, there's a lot of hype to it. And it's one of the biggest tournaments in the past few years for the Filipino community. And Mark spoke about it, that it's going to be opened up. And it's going to be one of the highlights of the summer with basketball tournaments. And especially for a lot of, you know, kind of overshadowing other tournaments. But, I mean, this is one of the best ones so far. And I can't wait for what Clyde and his team have done to build a revamp My Boy Cup into MCup in this summer coming up.
It's interesting because, like you said, it's open to other people. There's going to be some Chinese teams. There's going to be some... Basically, it's something that you aren't used to go to MCup and seeing that it's not just Filipino teams. And I think it's a good chance for the Filipino teams to hold their own. And again, it's just amazing to see that level, I guess, you know, up. Because it's different competitors. Sometimes you get used to playing the same people here and there. Mm-hmm. But I'm excited. There's also an NBA player, I think, that's coming. So, I'm not sure who it is. So
I think there's going to be mixed reviews too. Like, yeah, not just like the parents are going to have mixed reviews. Like, hey, why are you letting, yeah, you know, kind of ruining our tradition? But at the same time, there's also like, you know, players that are like, yeah, this is a way for me to level up my game to see how I fare, mm-hmm, not just with the Filipinos, but to other. But I think there's going to be a lot of parents complaining, like, oh, this person's too tall. This person is, you know, this person's too good. Like, you know, yeah, he's not even Filipino. And then why
that's basketball.
Ruining our tradition. There's going to be a lot of mixed reviews. So I'm excited. Mm-hmm. It's going to be so good.
Well, that's basketball. I mean, basketball's growing in the city, it's growing in Canada. So why not open up?